oldest buildings in Tredegar. It was built in the early 1700s, making it approximately 300 years old. I've only ever known it as a derelict old farmhouse, gated off and lifeless. However, it was once the heart of the village of Troedrhiwgwair, and has so many happy memories for anyone that visited it. The building was built long before the village, and was a working farm.
It wasn't until the late 1860s when Isaac Mason acquired the farm buildings and turned them into the only public house south of the clock. He called it the Rock and Fountain Inn. It would later be known as just the Fountain Inn, but would be called the farm by locals. In 1918, Isaac Mason's sons, Emrys and George, returned from World War I and took over the running of the pub. Although the pub would stay in the hands of the Mason family, it would be primarily because of Marjorie Gardner. Marge was born in number 44 Troedrhiwgwair in 1914. She left school age 14 and was employed as a housekeeper and barmaid at the inn. She married George Mason, and together they ran the pub. Following the death of both Emrys and George in the 1950s, Marge became the landlady, which is what she stayed as until the end of the century. Marge was a much-loved member of the village. She lived with her dog and cats, and only the customers for company for the next 40 years. Any children who visited the inn would call her Auntie Marge, and she would be known to give the local children Christmas cards with money inside. It was whilst Marge was the landlady that the farm saw some of its greatest times. The Royal Antediluvian Order of Buffaloes was based in the farm, with all the men of the village being enlisted when they came of age. Buffalo horns were displayed in the main room to mark this. It is said that when an Iron Bevan was councillor in Tredegar, he would drink in the farm, and who could blame him? The majority of people from the bottom end of Tredegar would state that the farm was where they had their first drink. It would usually be a pint of cider, drank outside in the long grass. If there was any reason to celebrate, the farm was the first place that anyone would visit. The 1977 Silver Jubilee would see the entire village in fancy dress and head into the pub. There would be bunting strewn everywhere, music playing, and the barbecue barrels would be lit. No one would leave before midnight, and a good time would be had by all. It didn't always have to be a special occasion, as the villagers of Trud could make any occasion special. Everyone would join in and do their best to make the parties enjoyable. Fred Thomas would play the music, and the locals would get up to give a song or perform a star tune. There was fancy dress and Easter bonnet parades. If anyone had a visitor from out of town, the farm was where you took them to enjoy some local hospitality. As Marge started to grow older, she was helped with the difficult task of running the pub by my auntie and uncle, Ray and Clive Davis. They would contribute to the good times with the legendary duck races down the river. And there was a huge VE celebration day, where once again, the bunting was strewn and the barbecues were lit. The farm was where you came in the summer. Families knew that their children were safe playing outside in the backfield and would send them off with a glass of lemonade and a packet of crisps. If you were lucky, you even got a pickled egg. The outdoor toilets never put anybody off. The ladies were situated out the back and was lucky enough to boast a door and a roof. The gents wasn't quite as luxurious, and consisted of two outside walls with guttering that were hosed down occasionally. All this just seemed to contribute to the unique night out that you would have at the farm. 1990s, Marge was in her 80s and could no longer stay safely in the farmhouse. She went into a retirement home and the pub was left in the capable hands of Ray and Clive. Marge sadly passed away in the year 2000, and tragically the pub closed after almost 140 years. Despite being a Grade 2 listed building, the Fountain Inn has sadly deteriorated over the last 20 years. Who knows what the future holds for this iconic building, but hopefully it will live on to have many more happy tales to tell.